Let's see one of the string matching or a pattern matching algorithm, and name of this algorithm is KMP algorithm. Why? Because these are the three scientists proposed this algorithm. Okay, now we'll see what exactly proposed here, and before going to that, first we'll understand the what is problem here. Okay, and the problem here is, let's suppose they will give some text and pattern. We need to find this pattern is present in the given text or not. That is the simplest problem we have to solve. Okay, and we have already seen one of the brute force approach or NeVe approach, right? In one of the previous videos, we have discussed one of the string matching algorithm called a NeVe based approach. Okay, what we have done in this NeVe based approach, every time we are going to compare each and every character, right? What I am telling you here is, let's suppose here my given pattern containing how many number of character, 5 number of character, and the given string containing how many number of character, 3, 6, 9, 12, 12 number of characters. Okay, according to the brute force approach, what we will do, we are going to compare, I am going to take this pattern. Okay, let's start from the static index of the string. Okay, that is the given text. Okay, now I am going to compare and starting characters of these two. Okay, that is A with A, S is matched. Then I will go to the next character, that is B with B, S is matched. Next I will go with the next character, that is C and C, S it's matched. Then I will go to the next character, that is D and D, S it's matched. Then last character A and F, we got a mismatch here. Okay, according to the brute force approach, what will we do? Again, we are going to start from this index, right? Okay, initially, okay, let's take this pointer. I'm going to start, take the one pointer, name it as I, and I'm going to name it as J here. Okay, initially what we have done here is, first we are going to start from 0th index. Okay, I is starting from 0th index. Okay, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. Okay, these are my indices of this string. Okay, then I am going to start the indices of J from 0. Okay, this is 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Okay, my I is at the 0th index and J is at the 0th index. Now I am comparing I and J. Okay, what is the value present in I and J are A and A. Yes, it's matched. Then I will increment the value of I, and as well as I am going to increment the value of J as well. Okay, right now my J is pointing to the first index and I is pointing to the first index of the text. Okay, then I will compare and the value present at I and J indices, that is B and B. Yes, it's matched. Then I will going to increment the value of I and as well as increment the value of J. Okay, then I will compare C and C. Yes, it's matched. Then I will go to increment the value of J as well as increment the value of I. Then I will compare the value present at the indices of I and J. In this case, D and D, yes, it's matched. Then what we have to do, we have to increment the value of I and as well as increment the value of J. In this case, there is a mismatch, that is A and F. Okay, then what will we do? According to the brute force approach, again, we will go back to the previous. Again, I'm going to start from the indices 1. Okay, we'll start what we have done in the initial step. We started from the first character, then I'm going to start from the second character. Then again, I will go back and I'm going to initialize my J with 0. Then I will repeat the same step, right? That is what we have done in the brute force approach, right? And what is the time complexity of this approach? This order of n into m, right? Okay, why? Let's take this worst case. Okay, let's take another example so that we can understand it, why it's order of n into m. Okay, let's suppose this is my given text and this is my pattern. How many number of characters present in this pattern? That is 4 number of characters. And in the text, how many number of characters? That is n is equal to 3, 6 and 8. Okay, and according to the brute force approach, what will we do? This is my indices of the pattern, 0, 1, 2 and 3. These are the indices, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Okay, and I'm going to take two pointers, that is I and J. Okay, then what we have to do, first I'm going to compare the values present at the indices I and J. In this case, A and S, S is matched. Then what we have to do, we have to increment the value of I and J parallelly. Okay, and A and A, S is matched. Then I will increment the value of I and as well as increment the value of J by 1. Okay, right now I am at the indices 2 and the value present in both the patterns or strings are same characters, that is A and A. Then I will going to increment the value of I and as well as increment the value of J. Okay, in this case, there is a mismatch. Okay, then what we have to do again, I will come to the first point, that is the first indices, and J will pointing to the 0th index. Okay, what is the drawback here? We are comparing again and again, right? We have seen there are 3 A's present and there are 3 A's, still we are going back to the previous indices. Okay, we have traversed 3 number of characters, we have seen some number of characters matched with the actual text, but there is a mismatch of single character. We are going back to the again the starting position. That is the main drawback of this brute force approach, right? Okay, that is why in the worst case, number of comparison it will take, in the worst case for each and every character we are going to compare with m time, there are n number of characters present in the text, then total time complexity of this brute force approach is order of n into m. Okay, then how to overcome this? Okay, that is why, and these 3 scientists proposed an algorithm, okay, based on this pattern, because we have seen some of the characters already visited and we have seen that appeared in the given text, but instead of repeating again and again, okay, they have proposed one algorithm, okay, that is called a KMP algorithm. Okay, let's understand the basic terminology of this KMP algorithm first. Later on we will see what exactly they have proposed it. Okay, let's suppose this is my given pattern. Okay, then, and first understanding this KMP algorithm, first we should understand the concepts of prefix and suffix. Okay, and we have already know about the prefix, right? Prefix is nothing but these are the subset of string present in a given input string. Okay, we'll start from the left side of the pattern. Okay, what I'm telling you here is the and in this example, A is one of the prefix and AB is also a prefix. I'm going to start from this left side, right? And ABC is also a prefix and ABCD is also a prefix. Okay, this is my given pattern. It's not a text. I'm just taking as a pattern here. Okay, and ABCDA is also one of the prefix. Okay, and so on. Okay, for this given string, these are the possible prefixes, right? And similarly, what about the suffix? Suffix will start from the right side of the string. Okay, that means C is one of the prefix and BC is also one of the prefix, sorry, suffix, and ABC is one of the suffix and DABC is one of the suffix, right? And so on. Okay, if you can carefully notice here is there any prefix which is same as suffix? Okay, A, I'm going to compare, A is present in the suffix or not, in this case no, right? And AB is present, no, and ABC, yes, there is a match. Okay, that means same string, okay, here that same prefix is appeared in the suffix. That means my some of the characters present in the beginning of the string and is also appeared in the later part of the string. Okay, that is the main observation done by these 3 scientists. Okay, and based on that they have designed an algorithm. Okay, and for that first they have to prepare a table called a pie table. Okay, and based on this concept, what we have observed here is there is a common prefix and suffix are there in the given input string. Okay, then how can we maintain a table? Based on that, once you maintain this table, okay, and construct this KMP algorithm is very, very simple. Okay, let's understand how to construct this pie table. For better understanding, instead of, you know, there is a terminology of prefix and suffix, instead of that I'm just maintaining beginning of, if there is any beginning of the characters is present, okay, beginning string is present in the later on any other string, okay, in the given input string, okay, then I am going to represent it in a pie table. Okay, I will show you here how can we construct a pie table here. Okay, now what I am going to do here is first I am going to start from A. Okay, and is there any A present later on in this string or not? I am going to check it. Yes, A is present and A is one more A is present and B is also present, right? And adjacent to each other, these two are adjacent to each other. Yes, A and B are present here and A and B are present here. Okay, then what I am going to do here is I am going to represent the indices. Okay, I am going to take the indices value here is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Okay, then what I am going to do here is I am going to put here for one time occurring and I am going to put it as the indices of that A here. Okay, and for similarly for B, I am going to put it as 2. And what about this case? It is 1 and 2 and remaining all I am going to put it as 0. Okay, for better understanding, I have taken this you know, indices start from 1 here, I have constructed a prefix or LPS table. Okay, LPS is nothing but longest prefix suffix table. Okay, I hope you understand this, right? What is prefix suffix table? That is the same substring is appearing later on in the same string. Okay, if you carefully notice this thing, AB is present here itself and AB is also appeared one more time. Okay, for that reason I am going to maintain one table here. We call it as the table as either pi table or a longest prefix suffix table. Okay, similarly let's take this example. Okay, let's start from A. A is appeared anywhere in the string? Yes, A is appeared here, A is appeared here. Okay, similarly B is appeared? Yes, B is appeared, AB is appeared, AB is appeared. Okay, and ABC is appeared? Yes, it's there, right? In the last string is appeared. Okay, for that first I'm going to maintain here 1. Okay, because of starting indices is 1 and B starting indices is 2, and similarly A 1, 2 and 3. Okay, remaining all characters I'm going to put it as 0. This is my prefix, longest prefix suffix table. I hope you understand this, right? Let's take this example. Okay, let's start from A. Okay, A is present anywhere else in the string? Yes, it's near to here, right? Then I'm going to put it 1 here, and similarly 1 is present here and 1 is here, and one more is present adjacent to each other, then I'm going to put it as 2. Okay, I hope you understand this, right? This is 1 and 2, and 2 is also containing the A. I'm going to put it as 2 here, and remaining all other characters I'm going to put it as 0. Okay, I hope you understand this, right? It's a very simple to construct a prefix suffix table, that is longest prefix suffix table. Once we construct this table, it's trivial to solve the KMP algorithm. Okay, this is the main logic and the main important thing for this KMP algorithm is construct a longest prefix suffix table. Okay, let's take this one more example. Okay, after that we'll go back to our actual algorithm proposed by the KMP algorithm. How can we find that pattern? Okay, and what about this one? Okay, how can we construct this table? That is, first I will start from A. A is appeared here, then I'm going to put it as 1, and A is, one more A is appeared, I'm going to put it as 2, and one more A is present, I'm going to put it as 3, because 1, 2, 3 adjacent to each other. Okay, then I'm going to put it as 1 and 2, and remaining all are zeros. Okay, this is the way of constructing a longest common prefix longest prefix suffix table or a pi table. I hope you understand this, right? With this many number of example, I hope you understand this, how to construct a pi table. Now we'll go back to our actual problem, actual algorithm proposed by the KMP algorithm. Okay, now we'll discuss how KMP algorithm works. Okay, let's suppose this is my given text and this is my pattern, and how many characters are present in this pattern? That is 5 number of characters. And how many characters are present in this text? That is 3, 6, 9, 12 and 15. 15 characters are present in the given input string. Then our main task is to find that given pattern is present in the text or not using the KMP algorithm. Okay, and the initial step, what we have to do, we have to construct a pi table. Okay, how to construct the pi table from the pattern? First I am going to check from A. A is anywhere present in the string or not? Yes, it's present, and I'm going to put it as 1. And B is present? Yes, I'm going to put it as 2. And as well as any other characters? No, right? I'm going to put remaining characters 0. Okay, let's draw this as a table. Okay, and I'm going to construct it, this table. This is my pi table. Okay, and how many characters are present? 5 characters are present in this given pattern. And what are the characters? That is A, B, A, B and D. Okay, right? And what are the values? That is 0, 0, 1, 2 and 0. Okay, here these are nothing but indices 1 and 2. That means we have seen this AB is appeared again. Okay, we to remembering the thing, we have constructed table here. We call this table as pi table, right? Now let's see how KMP algorithm works. Okay, then I'm going to put it as indices here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, and I'm going to start from 0. I'm going to take one more indices, that is 0. I'm going to take another variable called a j, which start from 0 here. Okay, for better understanding, you can also start from here. For better understanding, I'm going to start from 0 here. Okay, then as well as I'm going to take one more pointer I here. Okay, then what I'm going to do here is I'm going to compare my ith index value, that is A, and j plus 1 index value, that is A, right? And if there is a match, then what we have to do? I'm going to increment the value of I. Okay, then I move the pointer of I by 1 index, and similarly I'm going to move the pointer of j by 1 index. Right now my j is pointing to the first index, and similarly my I is pointing to the first index. Let's name this indices value. Okay, this is my first index. I'm just, for understanding purpose, I have just representing like this: 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12 13 14 and 15. Okay, right now I am at the second index. Okay, that is the second characters of the given input string. Then what we have to do, I'm going to check this j plus 1 index value, that is, what is the value? That is b. I'm going to compare the ith index value, that is b. Yes, it's a match. Then what I'm going to do here is, I'm just going to increment the value of I by 1. Right now my I is pointing to the third index and j is pointing to the second index, right? And again I will repeat the same step. Then how will we compare? That is ith value, that is a, and j plus 1 index value, that is a. Yes, it's a match. Then what we have to do? We have to increment the I and j one pointer ahead. My j is pointing to the third index, and similarly my I is pointing to the fourth index, right? Now then again I will going to compare j plus 1 index value, that is b, and ith value, that is the value present at the ith index, is b. Yes, there is a match. Then what we have to do? We have to increment the value of I by 1. Okay, right now I am at the fifth index. Okay, then I am going to increment the value of j by 1 index. Okay, right now I am at the fourth index of the j. Okay, then what we have to do? Again, I will repeat the same step. The value present at the j plus 1 index, that is d, I am going to compare with the ith index, that is ith index value is c in the given input string. Okay, there is a mismatch. Then what we have to do, instead of in brute force approach, what we have done, again this, we are backtracking this I to this first index, right? That is the second index. We are going back again and we are going to start from here. That is the main drawback of the brute force approach. Instead of doing that, what I am going to do here is, I am just moving my j from here. I want to move my j to this position, that is second position, because I have seen AB is already appeared in the given input string as well as the pattern. That is the reason, instead of moving my I back to the previous position, I'm just going back my J position. That means we have seen that AB is appeared one time already in the given input string. Okay, now right now my j at pointing to the second index. Okay, then again I will repeat the same step. Okay, then what is the value? J plus 1 value is a, and ith index value is c. Yes, there is a, again there is a mismatch. Then what we have to do, instead of moving back my I, then I'm going moving back my j to this position, that is the 0th position. Okay, that is the main advantage of constructing a longest prefix suffix table or a pi table, right? Instead of moving my I back to here, I'm just moving my I j here. Okay, right now my j is pointing to the 0th index. Okay, then again I will going to compare my j plus 1 index with the ith value. In this case, yes, there is a mismatch. My j is pointing to the 0th index, that means I am at the starting. Then what I will do here is, I'm going to increment the value of I by 1. Okay, then I'm going to compare it again. Okay, that means again I am at the starting position, there is a mismatch, then I'm going to increment the value of I by 1. Okay, then again I will repeat the same step. Okay, what we have to do? We have to compare the ith index value, that is a, and j plus 1th index value is a. Yes, it's a mismatch. Then increment the value of j by 1 and increment the value of I by 1. Okay, then j plus 1 value is b and ith value is b. Yes, it's a match. Then I'm going to increment the value of j by 1 and increment the value of I by 1. Okay, and j plus 1 value is a and ith value is c. That means there is a mismatch. Okay, right now I am at the 8th index of the actual string, that I is pointing to the 8th index, may j is pointing to the second index. Okay, there is a mismatch. Then what we have to do, instead of moving my I back to here, then I'm just moving my j pointer to this position, that is the 0th position. Okay, right now my j is pointing to the 0th position. Then I will repeat the same step. Then what we have to do, j plus 1th index is a, the value present at the j plus 1 index is a and ith index value is c, there is a mismatch. Then what we have to do, and right now I am at the starting position of j, then I am going to increment the value of I by 1. Right now I am at the ninth position of the I is pointing to the ninth position. Okay, then I will repeat the same step. Then I am compare j plus 1th index value is a and ith index value is a. Yes, it's a match. I am going to increment the value of j by 1 and I am going to increment the value of I by 1. Then I am going to compare j plus 1th index value, that is b. Yes, it's a match. Then I am going to increment the value of I by 1 and increment the value of j by 1. Then j plus 1th index value is a and ith index value is a. Yes, it's a match. Then I am going to increment the value of j and increment the value of I. Right? Then I am going to compare j plus 1th index value, that is b, and ith index value is b. Yes, it's a match. Then what we have to do? We have to increment the value of j by 1, okay, and increment the value of I by 1. Okay, and right now my j plus 1th index value is b, d, and ith index value is a. Okay, that is, there is a mismatch. Then what we have to do? We have to go back this position. Instead of moving back this ith position to back, here I am going to move my jth position according to this longest prefix suffix table. Okay, according to this, we have to move my j pointer from fourth index to the second index. Right now my j is pointing to the second index value. Okay, then what is the value present at the j plus 1th index value, that is a, and I am going to compare this ith value, that is a. Yes, it's a match. And what we have to do? We have to increment the both the values, that is j is pointing here and I is pointing to the 14th index. Okay, and I am going to compare j plus 1th index value is b and I plus 1th index value is b. Yes, it's a match. Then I am going to increment the value of I by 1 and increment the value of j by 1. I am going to compare j plus 1 and ith index value, that is d and d. Yes, it's a match. Then we find the pattern at this position. Okay, I hope you understand this, right? Then increment the value of I and we have reached the end of the string. Then we will stop the entire algorithm. I hope you understand this algorithm, right? It's a very, very simple algorithm once we able to construct this pi table or a longest prefix suffix table. Okay, then what is the time complexity of this approach? Okay, according to this algorithm, and if you can notice here, my I is traverse this entire input string only one time, right? Only one time. That means how many characters are present in this entire input string, that is n number of characters, that is, and also we have traversed this pattern, that is n plus m. I hope you understand this, right? Then overall time complexity of this problem is, this algorithm is order of n plus m. And what about the space complexity? We have constructed a pi table of size m, that is space complexity of this algorithm is order of m. Okay, and this is the better algorithm than the brute force approach, right? In the brute force approach, we have solved this problem in order of n into m. This is nothing but a quadratic time, and we have solved in a linear time, that is m plus n time. Okay, that is the basic advantage of, that is the beauty of the KMP algorithm, is by constructing a pi table. Okay, I hope you understand this, right?